The shortage of fuel in Uganda, especially in areas of Hoima and Kampala, continues to paralyze businesses, even after truck drivers at the Kenya-Uganda border, who have been protesting high charges of COVID tests, called off the strike. Rushan Lal Singh, the managing director of Amex Petrol Uganda Limited, says 16 trucks of fuel belonging to his company were stuck at the Busia border for over 1 week.
There is a slow movement of stock from Kenya to Uganda because of the jam and the strike at the border of Malaba and Busia on Kenyan side, which I think now the truck owners association, they have removed that strike. So now the things are getting normalized.
Singh explains that petrol stations have decided to hike fuel prices not to maximize profits but to hold on to the small available stock for longer. He dismissed allegations that fuel dealers are deliberately holding on to their stock to create artificial scarcity.
Most of the petrol stations or the petroleum marketing companies, these oil marketing companies, they are going dry. So what they are thinking is a human psychology. What they're thinking is better we increase the price, whether sales comes down and my station will not go dry. That's the economics. So just to bring the sales down, so the station should not go dry, most of the oil marketing companies, they have chosen a strategy of increasing the price. And most of the time it works very well.
Fuel dealers have now called upon the government to expedite construction of the 70 million litre fuel shortage terminal and Lake Victoria fuel transport system to provide petroleum dealers and the country with an alternative facility to store large volumes of fuel and save the country from feeling the pinch of hiccups in the petroleum sector.
Here in Uganda, we don't have a centralized storage where stock can be stored for to address such kind of crisis. So government has taken a very good step. I won't say government is not taking a step. Ministry of Energy and Petroleum Ministry, they are taking a very good step. They have taken, in fact, they are building a depot called Mahati in Entebbe, where the fuel will be transported through ferry.
It would be strategic as a country to ensure that we create mechanisms that can allow smoothening of the increments. Even if you have international disruptions, the increments should not be so significant and abrupt. One of the things that the government is doing, and we really want to applaud it for it, is to work on an alternative way of getting fuel into the country using the lake from Chisumu to the shores of Lake Victoria in Entebbe.
Francis Chisirinya, the Deputy Executive Director of the Private Sector Foundation Uganda, has warned that the current fuel hikes are going to trigger a crisis in the entire economy and called on the government to come to think of immediate solutions.
These rises are so significant within a very short time, and they're increasing the cost of doing business in Uganda. If they do, it means you are going to do have the cost of goods increasing, and this will put a lot of strain on consumers. Consumers are just coming out of the COVID pandemic and situation, so the least thing they need now is increases in prices.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.